putting in the same bag democracy, democratic countries, is absolutely wrong. So to me, frankly, there is only one democracy or few that work, Switzerland. So Switzerland is another kind. It's a direct democracy. I always say that in France, we elect a king for 5 years, right? Every 5 years, we elect a king. So it's not really a democracy. It's an election of a king. And it's actually a good approximation. And this is also the reason why, indeed, many of my colleagues or my friends, citizens are frustrated, of course. And that's why there is a yellow vest in the street. There is a lot of things. So, and similarly to many countries, I would say the democracy that work the best in the West are Switzerland and some northern countries like Norway, Denmark, a few like this, which are indeed the closest to the idealization of empowering the citizen and having a good deep. And also have, and very important, in Switzerland, we vote every 2 weeks. Right. We vote both for national things or international things of great interest, but also for deciding whether we are going to put the thrash on this left side on the or whatever, or to do some new light system or to. So what is the difference between the electing a king every 4 years, like in US, or 5 years, like in France, and direct democracy? Well, when you elect a king, you are a child. You essentially count on a big father who is going to promise you the best. And so this is essentially a system that doesn't work because of buying the votes of the electorate by the one who promised the most. And then, of course, a rush to not follow up on his promise when he's elected. In Switzerland, because the citizens are continuously voting and they see the consequence of their action, the first one for me, the biggest risk to conclude is inequality, because all this policy give rise to huge asset inflation, so asset growth. So if you are rich, let's say you are in the top 10% of the population or top 1%, and those who have get richer and richer. The problem is the 90% of the population in the West, which are wage earners, they cannot participate in this, and they are relatively become poorer and poorer. So in the West, we have the destruction of the middle class.